lack of modern machinery is not preventing China from building airfields. Where the Western powers are able to lay down runways almost overnight, China has to rely on coolie labor to take the place of bulldozers and petrol-driven concrete mixers. Despite the handicap, China stoically sets about the task. Gangs of laborers instead of tractors, muscle power where mechanical horsepower is lacking. The heavy roller has to be manhandled. But the job is done and the airfield ready for Allied bombers to use. When Vibo Valentia fell to the 8th Army, we secured an airport of considerable importance. Pictures of Allied bomb damage show the wholesale destruction of Axis aircraft, which preceded our occupation of this aerodrome in Calabria. From here, Allied planes were soon affording air cover in the general advance north. Parades down Broadway are no novelty, but this one is different from the usual run of things. Veteran British anti-aircraft gunners pass in review before a saluting base on which stand Sir John Dill and Mayor LaGuardia. The ACAC men are in the States to demonstrate the high degree of skill which good training and years of active service has affected. American Home Defense will pick up some valuable advice from them. Old soldiers never die. Even at a ripe old age, they still get around. At American 8th Air Force headquarters in Britain, the customary ceremony of beating the retreat, the lowering of the colour indicating the close of duty for the day, was witnessed by about 60 Chelsea pensioners of past campaigns. Veterans of many a famous battle marching again as a mark of respect to their hosts. The red-coated soldiers of distant wars may not have much admiration for modern warfare, but they recognize comradeship when they see it. Old soldiers of the old world and new soldiers of the new world, with that common bond of understanding which exists between men in uniform.